Hello and welcome to the GUSEK tutorial for beginners. In this video, you will learn the acronyms related to GUSEK. So grab a mug of coffee and let us get started. When I started learning about GUSEK, I was exposed to a series of acronyms such as MathProg, GLPSOL, Site, AMPL, IDE, GLPK, and GUSEK. My first reaction was to question why humans like acronyms so much. It took me some time to digest this soup of letters, so I decided to devote an entire video to this topic. This lecture aims to give a brief overview of programming languages, then explain what an IDE and a solver are. I will also talk about the GNU Linear Programming Kit and GUSEK. Now that you know the structure of the video, let's discuss programming languages. Have you ever thought about how you should write mathematical models on computers? The answer to this question is quite obvious. You need to use a mathematical programming language. Consider the mathematical model on your screen. A computer cannot solve this model as it is. You need to translate this model to the language that computers understand. One of the most famous mathematical programming languages is AMPL. As a curiosity, AMPL stands for a mathematical programming language. GUSEK uses GNU MathProg, which is a subset language of AMPL. So, the programming language that you learn in this series of tutorials is GNU MathProg. Now that you know about programming languages, we can move to the next topic, IDE. IDE stands for Integrated Development Environment. Let us understand what it is by returning to our example. We had a mathematical model and we translated it to GNU MathProg. Now, we need to type the programming model somewhere to solve it. One option would be to run directly on the terminal. The disadvantage is that it is harder to debug the code. Therefore, computer scientists developed a user-friendly environment that facilitates debugging. This environment is the IDE, and in the scheme, you can see a picture of GUSEK. In sum, an IDE is an interface that facilitates the programmer's work. Let's discuss solvers now. As of June 2021, some of the most famous solvers are GuruB, Cplex, Coin, and GLPSOL. The function of the solver is to perform all the calculations and solve the model. However, some of the solvers require a license, such as GuruB and Cplex. Even though GLPSOL is not as powerful as the others, the main advantage is that it is open source. GUSEK solver is GLPSOL, but keep in mind that it is possible to code in GUSEK and solve it with other solvers like Cplex. Now let's return to the scheme. After translating the model to GNU MathProg, the user types it on GUSEK. Then he or she compiles the model and runs it. GUSEK will automatically call GLPSOL. Then, when GLPSOL finishes the calculations, GUSEK can display the results to the user. Let's move to the final topic, programming kits. GUSEK uses a programming kit called GLPK. The acronym means GNU Linear Programming Kit. GLPK has two main components. It connects the GNU MathProg language to the GLPSOL solver. Your next question may be, what about GUSEK? GUSEK means GLPK under Site Extended Kit and is an open source IDE for GLPK. In other words, GUSEK is an IDE based on Sight, which is the Scintilla-based text editor. GUSEK combines the Sight text editor with GLPK. Let me summarize this soup of letters to you. First, you have a mathematical model. Then you need to translate it to GNU MathProg and write it on GUSEK. And finally, GUSEK will ask GLPSOL to solve your model. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial on GUSEK for beginners. Stay tuned for the upcoming videos.